Hello, so we are moving to our practical number 3, that is design and develop the app demonstrating the simple downstream messaging. Here we are going to work with Firebase messaging system and we'll see how to connect with Firebase messaging system and send the notification. So let's start. Xview software's Android Studio and we need to enable the Google services. Here are the steps to execute. You need to connect your app to Firebase. Later on, you need to add the FCM to your app. Then you need to handle the messages. And the last part is to send the notification. So let's start. So let us see our step number one, that is connect your app to Firebase. So let us open the Android Studio and start doing practical one by one. So let's start with the practical. You need to choose your project, select the empty activity, give it a name like the Firebase demo. Okay, and now click on the finish. In this way, you have created a new project. So now we are ready with our Android Studio. Now you need to log in. So here at your right side, you have an icon, sign in Google. You need to click that icon and just sign in. Here, you need to enter the password and you need to allow all these activities like the view and manage your data across the Google Cloud Platform services, view and manage your application deploy on Google App Engines, view and manage your actions on Google, and the view and administer all the Firebase data and setting. Just click on the allow. Here, you will get the success window. And now you need to enter into the Firebase. So just click on this Firebase. Here you will get the console. Go to console. And now this is your console. Whatever you are creating the projects, that will be displayed over here. Here is click link for the documentation. You can click and go to the documentation. Now let's go back to our Android Studio. So in this way you are signed in. Now select the tools and click on the Firebase. Click on Cloud Messaging and set up Firebase Cloud Message. Here you are supposed to do your first step, that is connect your app to Firebase. Click on the connect to the Firebase. It will start connecting. Okay, here you are supposed to give the project name. So I will give the Firebase demo. Select your country as India. And click on connect to the Firebase. Now just see here, we are getting a green tick connected. That means that you are completed with your first step. Now let's move to the step number 2, that is add FCM to your app.
So here we have interface. Now the second step is to add HTML to your app. Here we are going to make the changes in Gradle, but just clicking on add HTML to your app, that changes will be done. Now here we are going to change the build.gradle and you're going to add the com.google.gms:google-services-4.2.0. You need to add Firebase plugin. That plugin should be added over there. And the last one is that you need to add the dependencies. That is com.google.firebase:firebase-messaging:17.3.4. It is a version. Now I suggest you to update your Android Studio so you will get the latest version. Also upgrade your SDK so that version will be accepted by your studio. Otherwise you need to find out which is good suitable SDK for your application. So here now I will click on the accept changes. Now see here, the dependency is set up correctly. That means you have completed with your step number 2. Now let us focus on the step number 3, that is we need to handle the messages. For handling the messages, we need to create the notification as we did in practical number 1 and 2. So you can refer the practical number 1 and 2 as how to create the notification. The second one is to use the Firebase messaging service, we need to add some services in our app manifest, that is AndroidManifest.xml. So we need to add the fire messaging service. So that should be added over here. And we need to add the intent com.google.firebase.messaging event. So we can receive the messages. Then we need to subscribe the client app to a topic. Now what is the meaning of a topic? Now just, we have 4 streams like FYBSC, SYBSC, TYBSC and MSC. And the next one is all. So whenever we are dealing with FYBSC, that will be created as a group and the message will be sent only to the FYBSC. The same thing we are going to send to the SYBSC. Same thing we are going to do for the TYBSC. And for all, the message will send to all. So here, we need to subscribe to topic that is defined by the user. You need to add the complete listener. We need to find out whether it is completed or not. So the message will be like this, successful or failed. And that will be displayed. So it will receive the message. This is only for the receiving the message. Whatever you are going to receive, that should be done in the notification manager. Now let's focus on our Android Studio work. As we did in practical number 1, we are going to define the notification channel. So this is a way of creating notification channel. We need to find out with the correct SDK. So notification channel, I'm giving the ID as a Firebase message. Please focus on this ID because now we are going to use this ID. The rest thing is same as practical number 1. In this way, we have created the notification channel. Now we need to create the Firebase service. So I will go to the package where the main activity is. I will right click on that particular package. Go to the new, select the Java class. Give the name to the service, let it be Firebase service. That name might be reserved, so I will just put D, so Firebase service D. I need to give the superclass, it will be Firebase messaging service. Now you can click on OK. So a Firebase service D is created. Now just press Ctrl O. You need to add this service, that is on message received. Double click on that service, that will be added automatically. Now you are able to receive the messages, and now you need to display that message. So I will create one method, public void display notification. It is a user defined method. I will pass two strings as an input, string title and string message. Now here I need to add the notification manager compact. Now just see here, I have written a method for the display notification. I have written the notification compact builder, and here you are going to give this channel ID as a Firebase message where you have given this while creating the notification channel. Then you need to display the title, you need to display the text, and for this you can refer our practical number one. Now you need to call this method in on message received. So I will call, say, display notification. I need to display the title as well as I need to display the message. So I will go like this, remote message dot get notification dot get title comma remote message dot get notification dot get message or get body. Okay, so in this way I'm going to display the messages that are received from Firebase. As we discussed in step number 3, we need to create the topic. So here we have created the topic. In onComplete method, if it is successful, it will display as a successful. Otherwise, it will display as a fail, and that would be displayed as a toast. Here I will write a topic name as a MSC. Okay, so now we are done with all the formalities. Now let us focus on the step number 4, that is send notification. So we need to send the notification from Firebase Cloud Messaging Service. So for this purpose, you need to go to your Firebase console. Just refresh your console. See here, we have Firebase demo project that we have created. So click on that project. When you are connecting your Firebase, the project will be created automatically. Go to the Grow tab. Click on the Grow tab. Click on Cloud Messaging. Here you need to send your first message. Give the option. Give the notification title. Welcome. Give the text. Welcome to Firebase. This is practical number 3 and aim is to create simple downstream message . The rest things are optional, so I will click on next. Here I will go to the topic. I will write the MSC. If you want to send to user segment, you can select your app like this, or you can select your topic like this. So I will click on the next. I will schedule now. Next, I will set a review. I will not publish, because before publishing, I need to run my app. Now we have completed all formalities, and now we need to add this service. So go to the manifest, go to the Android manifest.xml,
below activity and just before application, you need to paste code. So below activity and before application, you need to paste this code. Okay, so I will paste this code. Here you need to change your Firebase service. Now my Firebase service is Firebase service B. So that will be changed automatically once you write down this name. That is Firebase service. So it is coming automatically. So you can click on that particular service. Now you are completed with your application. Now you can run your application. So your application has built successfully, and now let's check the output. For checking output, now I will click on the publish and I will see the output whether the notification is coming or not. So click on the publish. So this is your application. Now let's check whether the notification is coming or not. I will send one more notification. So I have written a title as a welcome, notification text as a welcome to Firebase programming. This is a demonstration of simple downstream message. Next, we'll give topic as MSC. Next, schedule next, review. And publish. Here you can check your notification. Thank you.